Welcome to this session on AES encryption and decryption. As mentioned in our AES keys video, we will present the subject without going deeper into its mathematical context. We intend to cover that part of AES in another video to be released shortly. Our approach is to learn by practicing. We therefore recommend that you download AES 128 ENCRDECR.xlsx from the link given in the description part. In that Excel workbook, we use formulae and functions that are part of MS Excel and not our own macros. Please also download nist.fips.197.pdf from csrc.nist.gov/publications/fips listed under number 197. Our Excel book uses the sample case given in the appendices A and C of that PDF. It would therefore become much easier for you to follow our workings and also validate the results with those given in the document. We recommend that you view our AES key expansion video before continuing with this session. The link to that video is given below in the description part. In our AES key expansion session, we left off after generating the round keys or the key schedule using 128-bit, 192-bit, 256-bit cipher keys. In this session, we'll consider 128-bit encryption and decryption. The videos for 192 and 256-bit encryption will be published shortly. We'll use the AES 128 ENCRDECR.xlsx workbook and refer to Appendix C on page 35 of the FIPS.197.pdf. Enter the 16-byte plain text given in that PDF in cell range B3 to Q3 and the cipher key in the cell range B4 to Q4 in the summary sheet. All values are in hexadecimal. These values are split word by word and filled in appropriate columns in cell ranges B7 to E10 for plain text and in F7 to I10 for cipher key. The keys are automatically copied to cell ranges B3 to E6 in the keys sheet and the cell range B3 to E6 in the AES 128 sheet. Cell range B5 to Q5 under your ciphertext is for you to use later if you wish to decrypt your own ciphertext. It may be ignored for now. Let us now go to keys sheet. With the cipher key copied from cell range F7 to I10 of the summary sheet, the round keys are automatically computed as explained in our earlier video. These are the keys that would be used in AES encryption decryption. So these values are copied from cell range C9 to F52 of this sheet to range R3 to U46 of the AES 128 sheet. Please note that the key schedule for decryption is copied in the reverse order in cell range R53 to U96. Let us now work on AES encryption. AES 128-bit encryption consists of 10 iterations. We also have an initial XOR operation of the key with the plain text. That makes the number of round keys required to 11. Each round involves the following 4 steps. substitute bytes, shift rows, mixed columns, add wrong key. Substitution bytes. Substitute bytes is generally called sub-bytes, which involves substitution of every byte with the values from S box. This is given in the data sheet of the workbook. These values are generally given as 16 by 16 lookup table. We have converted this 16 by 16 table as a 256 rows lookup table so that we could use VLOOKUP function on the MS Excel. These values are not just selected randomly, but each substitution entry in the lookup table is created by using a multiplicative inverses in the Galois field 2^8. It is then bit scrambled using affine transformation to remove bit level correlations inside each byte. In our data sheet, we have given the Galois inverse of each hex value under cell range AW3 to AX258. The working of affine transformation is shown in our data sheet. Consider the inverse of V2, which is 1F. Then apply affine transformation and final XOR operation. The output now becomes 37. This is the substitution value for B2 in the S box. Check cell A181 and you will find 37 as the substitution value for B2. The column C gives the decryption value. For 37, the value that we have substituted now, the decryption value is given in cell C57, which is B2, the value that we began our example with. So, we are able to retract the original value. This is the logic behind construction of S-box substitution values. Unlike DES, which had 8 S-boxes, in AES, we have only 1 S-box. Shift rows. The shift rows transformation consists of no shifting in the first row, circular shifting from second row by 1 byte to the left, circular shifting from third row by 2 bytes to the left, circular shifting from the last row by 3 bytes to the left. Remember, while filling the plain text inside the block, we filled each word in one column. That is, the first 4 bytes of the input block filled the first column, the next 4 bytes in the second column, and so on. Therefore, if we shift the rows now, as described above, its effect is to scramble up the entire byte order. This is a state. This is a state with 4 rows and n d columns. Here it is 4 columns. And the mixed column transformation acts on each column. This column can be treated as a polynomial. This. Okay. And we will take it that the polynomial as a solution, this value, the coefficients 3, 1, 1, 2. This is given here also. See this? We have this. Now, for the sake of more space, we are moving here. See, we have copied that shift rows here, and the polynomial array is given here. When we use this polynomial, multiply with this, we get the these four values, and we have to XOR them. That way, we get the first value. See, the first column again. Again, if you use this same and multiply with this, we get the second value. Again, we use the same polynomial and multiply with this, we get the third value. And we use the same polynomial and multiply with this, we get the fourth value. But before doing this, we have to do an XOR of each multiplication. Result has to be XOR, this XOR with this, and the outcome XOR with this, and the outcome XOR with this. This XOR with this, and the outcome of this XOR with this, and these three XOR with this, and we get the final result. In this, and this setup operation are same. This is just a formula, and this is actual working. This is how. Now for the next mix column, we take this polynomial again, apply the same calculation. This is multiplied with this, and then we do an XOR to get the second value. Again, we take the same thing, multiply with this polynomial, and XOR the results, we get the second value, and so on. And this is how we compute the entire mixed column value. Here you get the formula. Finally, this is the value we have obtained here. And this actual calculation is here. This is nothing but we have XOR'd these two and written it here. And this with this is XOR'd written here. And this with this and written is here. This is the final value. Similarly, for the second column, column 2, column 3, column 4. Decryption is the same reverse value. We will come to it later. It is easy for you to check the we take the value from the decryption column. We take the value from the decryption. See, this is taken, and column by column we apply this transformation. But this time we use the inverse solution. That is, we use 0b, 0d, 09, 0e. We use this one. This is again shown here. This is the inverse. So it's same thing. This polynomial multiply with this, and the result is XOR to get this. This is how mixed column values are computed. For the sake of simplicity, we have expanded the above operation in this sheet. The actual workings in AS128 sheet involves a compound formula which you may analyze and understand its implementation of this expanded operation as given in the sample mixed column sheet. The output is the ciphertext for that round concerned. This ciphertext is XORed with a round key for the next round. This concludes one round of operation. At the end of the 10th round, we don't do the mixed call operation, but only the XOR operation with the last round key, and we get the AES ciphertext. AES decryption. In decryption, like in DAS, the key would be used in the reverse order. Notice that cell range R53 to U96 point to the keys in key sheet in the reverse order. In encryption, we began with the input state array being XORed with the first 4 words of the key schedule. The same thing happens during decryption, except that we now XOR the ciphertext state array with the last 4 words of the key schedule. For decryption, each round consists of the following 4 steps: inverse shift rows, inverse substitute bytes, add round key, and inverse mixed columns. Note the difference between the order in which the substitution and shifting operations are carried out in a decryption round vis-a-vis the order in which similar operations are carried out in the encryption round. The third step consists of XORing the output of the previous 2 steps with the 4 words from the key schedule. The fourth step is inverse mixed column operation, which is the inverse of what has already been explained in encryption. Please note that the sub-bytes and shift rows commute, which means the order of the operation does not matter. Either you can shift and substitute or vice versa. You get the same result. This is true for inverse operation too. This is because the sub and shift order does not matter. You may experiment with the Excel sheet by shifting these 2 operations. We have carried the ciphertext and the decrypted plain text to the summary sheet under cell range T3 to AI3 and T4 to AI4 respectively. If you wish to decrypt your own ciphertext, then enter it in cell range B5 to Q5. The encryption key should also be entered if it is different. Set the toggle cell value to 1, then you will get the plain text in cell range T4 to AI4. You may now experiment with various keys in plain text to get a firm grip on AES 128-bit encryption decryption algorithm. Thank you. We'll meet again in another session on AES 192-bit encryption decryption algorithm. Bye until then.